Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Ashok. In the last session, we discussed about different versions of for loop with their examples. Now, in this session, we are going to discuss about nested for loop with its example and use of break and continue keywords in the for loop with its examples. Now starts the example of nested for loop. So what is nested for loop? The for loop, one for loop contains another for loop, then the for loop is called as nested for loop. Now see the example. Suppose this is a for loop. This is one for loop. So I is equal to 1. So I write here I is equal to, suppose 3. Okay, I is less than or equal to 3. So this is the one for loop. So I write another for loop inside this for loop. Okay, for, I use the j variable for this, j equal to 1, j is less than or equal to, suppose right here 5 and j plus plus. These are the two for loops. So this is called outer for loop from this to this, and this is called as inner for loop. Okay, so outer for loop is useful for this for the rows, that is mostly rows, and the inner for loop is useful for the columns itself. Okay, so now see the how the for this nested for loop is executed. So I write here printf %d. I'm going to print the value of j here. I mention here the value of j. If j is equal to, value of j will be displayed here. Right, j is equal to this. Okay, right, use the slash t also for the tab. This one, printf. I also print the value of I in this loop, that is the outer loop body, that is a %d. Then I'm going to print value of I here in the outer loop. So this is the outer loop statement and this is the inner loop statement. Okay. Right here slash n. So each time every looping termination looping iteration, it will goes to the new line. Okay. So I write here slash n. I is equal to. So now see the output of this program. So here see, I use the outer for loop, that is the I variable for the outer for loop variable, outer for loop, and the j variable loop counter variable for the inner for loop. So here I is equal to 1, then j will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. When I is equal to 2, j will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. When I is equal to 3, j is goes to the 1 from 1 to 5. So here, what you understood? Here, for each iteration of the outer for loop, the inner for loop is executed. For each iteration of the outer for loop, inner for loop will be executed totally. Okay, meaning her each iteration, the inner for outer for loop ka iteration hai, us iteration ko inner for loop totally execute ho jayega. Okay, understood it? Okay, so that's why I'm display the this value of I here and value of j here. Okay, got it? Okay. So take another example of this nested for loop. So I am going to print here star only. It star. Okay. Now see the output here. So here the entire line will be displayed as a star. Okay. So here the outer for loop is useful for rows purpose. Okay. So here I mentioned new line character here. Printf slash n. I'm writing here only slash n because I want to go into new line as each iteration of the outer. Now see the example. See the output. So here for I is equal to 1, this star will be displayed, that is inner for loop executed. So when I is equal to 1, 5 times stars will be displayed. Then next it goes to this new line character, and again for I equal to 2, the 5 stars will be displayed. Okay, then next I is equal to 3, and again 5 stars will be displayed. Okay, so this is the output. Now check the output here. Suppose I change the value of, instead of 5, writing 5, I mention here I. Now check the output. So here, when I is equal to 1, the inner loop will be executed only one time because here value of I is equal to 1. Next, when I is equal to 2, the inner loop will be displayed 2 times star. That is this. And when I is equal to 3, the inner loop will be executed 3 times. That is, the star will be displayed how many times? 3 times. Okay. So this is the nested for loop, example of nested for loop. Now see, that is the second point. How to use break and continue statement in the for loop. So instead of use directly the programming, so let's know the use of break statement. So use of break statement is used to terminate or break the loop, any loop, that is for loop, while loop or do while loop. So here I am going to use the break statement firstly. Okay, let's check the output. Suppose I write here I is equal to 1, I is less than or equal to 5, and here I write break. Okay. If you use break here directly, then at the first iteration it will be break. Okay, so here the break should be mentioned in the condition. That is, condition specifies what? When the loop will be breaked. So suppose if I is equal to 3, then I want to break the loop. Okay. Printf %d, then let's see the output of this program. Right here slash n. The output here, the output is 1 and 2 only, because when I is equal to 1, the condition is false, it does not break the loop, it will display the value of 1. When I is equal to 2, again it does not break the loop, it will display the 2, value of I is 2. Then when I is equal to 3, if condition is true, then it will break this loop. So output will be only 1 and 2 word. Okay, now check the use of continue keyword. What is use of continue keyword? So continue take the next iteration of the loop, any loop, it is for loop, while loop or do loop. Okay, so your continue statement takes the next iteration of the loop. Okay, so check the program. When I is equal to 3, I want to continue, that is I want to take the next iteration directly. Okay, so continue and check the output. 1, 2, 4, 5. Okay. So here, if I is equal to 3, it goes to the next iteration, that is I plus plus, that is I is equal to 4. Then condition is true, then 4 will be printed. That is 1, then 2, then 3. If I is equal to 3, it will take the next iteration, that is I equal to 4. Then it will print the I value, that is 4. Then I equal to 5, and it will terminate the statement. That is continue keyword, take the next iteration of the loop. So this is the use of break and continue statement in the for loop. Okay. So thank you for watching this session. If any queries, then ask me.